Welcome to Legally Bound, Business and Real Estate Explained. Today, we're tackling a hot topic that's been buzzing in the Virginia landlord tenant scene. Is your landlord liable for the criminal acts of others? Before we jump in, smash that like, subscribe, and follow button. Let's get into it. Imagine this. You rent a cozy apartment. You love your space. But then something happens. A crime right in your building. You're shaken. You're stirred. And you're wondering, is my landlord responsible for this? Under Virginia law, the general rule is pretty clear. A landlord is not a superhero with a cape ensuring your safety from every bad guy out there. They're not typically liable for a third person's criminal acts. In Klingbeil Management Group versus Vito, for example, a landlord failed to install a deadbolt lock on the tenant's apartment door. The tenant was raped in a rental unit by an unknown person and sued the landlord claiming that he was negligent. While the jury ruled in favor of the tenant, the Supreme Court reversed on appeal, holding that the landlord had no common law duty to be an insurer of the tenant's safety. But there are exceptions, folks. So, when does a landlord become liable for the intentional criminal acts of others? First, the law says that if, for example, your landlord states in the rental contract that he will provide for the security of the tenant and fails to do that, then that could be an actionable basis for the tenant to claim that there was a breach of contract. Second, the case law in Virginia appears to put some emphasis on the foreseeability of the crime as a factor in determining whether the landlord should be held liable in tort or not. If there is a foreseeable risk, like a series of break-ins, and the landlord hasn't done zilch, well, that's when the law might just tip the scales against the landlord. Compare the two cases of Dean v. Charles E. Management, Inc. and Pellet v. Brandon LP. In Deem, the resident manager who was returning to her apartment was beaten and sexually assaulted by an unknown person in the parking lot. In Pellet, on the other hand, the tenant was assaulted in an unlit parking lot. In Deem, the landlord was held to be not liable for the tenant's injuries because there was no evidence that the absence of lighting in the parking lot was a cause of the assault. In contrast, the landlord in Pellet was held liable because the criminal activity in that case was foreseeable. So, where does that leave us? In Virginia, your landlord isn't your guardian against all evils. They must keep the building from falling on your head, but they're not always responsible for actions of the shady character in the parking lot, unless they've promised to be and didn't follow through, or unless it was clearly foreseeable to the landlord and he didn't do anything about it. Remember, folks, knowledge is power, and if you've enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and follow, and share this video with your friends. See you in the next video.